Welcome to the Rodney Anderson Radio Show.
Social media is a big thing.
He's on Tinder.
And could Facebook envy lead to symptoms of depression?
Absolutely.
Yeah, it could.
I mean, you're sitting there, you're looking at all the fancy pictures because your ex-wife or your ex-husband is on a vacation. And you're not taking them anymore because you don't have any money.
And I see my friends are taking their little kids to Disney World, and I'm not taking my little nugget to Disney World. And it makes us feel bad about ourselves. And we thought we would have Lori Vann chime in. She's a licensed professional counselor. She joins us on the line now. Good morning, Lori.
Good morning.
Thanks for being with us, Lori. Facebook is a major, 1.4 billion users of Facebook now, I saw the other day. And so, Lori, how many people are on these on Facebook that they can come into your office, deal with depression over some of the things that they're witnessing on Facebook?
Well, I think there are several of my clients, especially teenagers, I will say that they do get upset about what they're seeing on Facebook, either the comparison of, oh, look how great their life is, or, oh, they now have a new relationship. What's the problem with me? Why am I not in a relationship? And for the younger set, I think they've moved away some from Facebook, but they have Instagram or they have other social media accounts because there's something new every other week for them. But for adults as well, I think the adults struggle with the envy thing and that comparison.
Of course, and we look at our high school like reunion pages, whether you're out of high school 5 years or 50 years, and you're looking how great they are, and they have the house, and they have the vacation. Even, it doesn't matter. It doesn't discriminate ages because you always are looking back and saying, how come I didn't end up like that?
Absolutely. I think one of the first questions that needs to be asked before you even create a social media account is, what is my motivation behind this? What is my purpose? What am I trying to get out of this? And if the motivation is anything other than, I just want to connect with friends and family, and this is one way to find out what's going on with their life, but it doesn't affect how I see myself, then okay, that's great. But there are a lot of people out there that are insecure, that do struggle with comparing themselves to other, and it creates feelings of inferiority, which go with depression or even anxiety.
Yeah, and do you ever have couples come in, and when they come into your office, the husband or the wife is addicted to Facebook, and they're on it a majority of the day?
It hasn't so much been the addiction part, but what I have had happen is, unfortunately, that's where a lot of affairs have started, is that people start to connect with former high school sweethearts or whomever, and they start to chat, and then they start to think, well, things were so much better back then versus what I have now. And there have been many affairs that have started because of social media.
Yeah, I think that's the truth, Lori, and this is Susie, by the way. You know, one thing when you're talking about the envy that it creates and how people need to know what their motivation is for getting on there, I think, too, people need to realize and think about the fact that Facebook, you only see what they want you to see. So if I want to put up my best foot forward so that everybody sees how happy my marriage is, how pretty my kids are, how successful I am in my business, whatever the case may be, I'm not going to put out there, you know, the insecurities. I'm not going to put out there that, you know, the things that you don't want everybody to see. So envying someone based on what they put on Facebook is usually creating some kind of a false, they've usually created some kind of a false, nobody can possibly compete.
That is such a good point, because it's like a first date. Facebook is first date. No one's really telling the truth. Everyone's painting a prettier picture than it is. Yeah. Everyone's holding their cards close. So you're not really getting to know somebody.
It's like, oh my gosh, their marriage is so perfect. Their kids are so perfect. They never fight. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Yeah. And sometimes the worst offenders are the ones who, it is so bad that I'm going to put it up here to make sure nobody knows how bad it is.
Yep.
And also, Facebook is everybody's TMZ.
Sure.
They got to be a celebrity.
And everybody's got to
be a celebrity. I got to be Amy Vanderhoff, and I want to be her.
Well, yeah. I mean, that goes without saying.
All the time. Lori, how much is too much time on Facebook at work?
Well, I know that when they've done different surveys, people actually spend much more time on social media than what they realize. And it's so easy to do because you get sucked in watching this little 2-minute video or doing this 2-minute survey, or, oh, I just need to do a little update here. And before you know it, you've spent a half hour, an hour, or maybe multiple hours. And if people just leave their account up throughout the day and then they get the little notices of, oh, someone commented on something you did, then it takes you back to the page and you get distracted. And so I think people probably do waste quite a bit of time at work doing the social media stuff and not really focusing on the job that they're being paid for.
And do you think the fact that Rodney's brought that up three times might be an indication that perhaps his status is that he's having an issue with somebody in the office
now,
that's
listen,
on Facebook too much?
Here's the thing. I judge on TV and radio how much I post. Certainly in TV, they have a certain amount of times I have to be on Facebook and Twitter during the day. So I am in commercial breaks. Me and my ADD is on Facebook and Twitter.
But how many times are you scrolling through everybody's stuff?
Not really.
The news feed. I mean,
do you scroll through all the news
feed? I get on there a couple of times a day just to see what's going on, whether it's taking a 5-minute break or
it's
whatever.
Tough for it not to snowball. You know how you see something? Oh, what's that? Let me check that real quick, just real quick.
Yeah.
Oh,
I don't have that issue, but I do see a lot of people that can go down those rabbit holes. Somebody that'll pull something up and then go, oh, look at that.
I do it in bed at the end of the day. And I'm scrolling through the news feed. It's like my bedtime story. And then I wonder why I can't sleep because I've been staring at this phone for 30 minutes.
So, Lori, what's the solution here? Do people, they probably just need to come to you to deal with all their Facebook posts.
Yeah. What's the correlation here with human behavior and what you do?
Well, I think that it gets to that insecurity. It gets to that motivation of, again, why are you posting things on there and why are you really looking at everyone else's status? If it's for the genuine, hey, I really do care, and if they get to go to an awesome vacation, I'm happy for them. It doesn't mean that I'm a failure. But unfortunately, a lot of people don't have that self-awareness. They're not really in tune with how impacted they are by other people's posts and that comparison. And it gets to, well, they probably have some self-esteem issues to begin with, and that it might be more performance-based in a matter of speaking where they go, well, I'm only as good as what vacation I do or what job I have or how awesome my relationship is or how many likes I have for the latest selfie that I've posted.
That's all. And everything you just said is me.
Yeah.
Aw.
Hey, Lori Vann is her name. She is a licensed professional counselor. Lori, how does everybody find you?
Well, I have a website. It's LoriVannCounseling.com. You can also check me out on my YouTube channel, Lori Vann, LPCS. And I do have a Facebook presence of Caregiver's Guide to Self-Injury. Or you can just email me at Lori@LoriVann.com.
And it's V-A-N-N for everybody out there. Lori, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks.
I'm going to like you on Facebook today, Lori Vann.
Everybody, get the hell off of Facebook. We got business to do around here. All right.
I'm going to like you on Facebook, but it's not going to be until after 5:30.
All right. Yes.